Good morning from Panhandle Outdoors, America's only daily outdoor TV show. Your source for fishing, hunting, and information for folks who enjoy the great outdoors. Now sit back, relax. It's Panhandle Outdoors.
Good morning, folks. Welcome to Panhandle Outdoors in Winston, Chester. Glad you're here this Friday morning. We're in a great week with a special guest here. It has been a good week on Panhandle Outdoors. We've done some great bass fishing, or had one of the best bass fishermen around, catching bass number 45,000. We had Big Jim on yesterday. Now we got another guest today. We're going to talk about the new kayaks coming out. So let's get started. Our weather brought to us by Haney Technical Center at the corner of Baldwin and Highway 77. High today 75, low 66. And check this out. The water temperature has jumped up to 66 degrees. That's usually a March water temperature. So it's really been fascinating to watch it do that. You know, last week it hit 64, I was surprised, but now it's 66. So we might have the Spanish run early this year. Take a look at the river readings brought to us by our new sponsor, Sandhill Seafood, up there on Highway 77. We're going to have them coming on soon. Apalachicola Blountstown, 7.2. Choctahatchee Caribbean, 8.3. And Apalachicola is going down, but the Choctahatchee is going up. And that's the rain we had some last week. But 8.3 at the Choctahatchee. Tide chart brought to us by Kent Forest Lawn Funeral Home and Cemetery. You got a low tide at 3:22 this morning. Now it's starting to come in right now. It's going to come in all the way to about 4:13 this afternoon. We've got some bad weather forecast, so just be aware of what's going on. We've got a marine forecast is coming in at south-southwest at 10 to 20. So it's going to be strong, so be careful if you're outdoors, especially, you know, on the water in the woods by yourself. Be real careful. Let's go ahead and do our fishing game times today. Let's do them right now. 6:07 to 8:07 this morning. This evening, 6:29 to 8:29. All right, that wraps up our weather for the weekend. Let's go ahead and take our break. We'll be back with our guests. Welcome back, and welcome this year to Brad Stevens.
Happy New Year, Coach.
Happy New Year. 2017 is here.
We're here, and we're rocking.
And how was your holidays?
Man, it was better than it should have been.
Santa Claus good to the girls?
Santa Claus was great to the girls. So I don't know what they did. My youngest was so scared to death, she thought she was going to get coal. So I had her convinced she was actually good. So when it came time to do stockings, when she got to the end of it, she jumped up and down and screamed. She's like, I didn't get coal. So, but she was really surprised that Daddy didn't get coal. That's the part that really got me.
The child's mind is just special.
Isn't it? Absolutely.
All right, so you had to go back to work after Christmas.
I did.
Pay for Christmas.
Got to go pay for Christmas. So we took... We always take the week between New Year's and Christmas off, or Christmas and New Year's, depending on which way you look at it. And then we go to Nashville. My mom's from Nashville. Mm-hmm. So we go to Nashville. We spend, you know, 3 or 4 days in Nashville, my grandparents, you know, and then, you know, seeing the sights and running around town and going downtown. They always have the Music City Bowl, then they always have the Nashville. They do a big New Year's Eve production. We're out of there before all the craziness starts. But we get to go down kind of like that day before the festival.
Oh, yeah.
They're setting up. I mean, they got sound checks here and there. So it's really cool.
That's good. I saw some posting on it. It looked like y'all had a great time.
Absolutely.
Okay, but when you got back to work, you had some 2017 stuff coming
Absolutely,
in.
Which we've had 2017, as most of y'all know, since October, November-ish. Mm-hmm. But this January, it's January. Forget that. Forget I said it's January. It's 80 degrees outside. It's springtime. Now it's going to get cold again. I don't know. I can't predict the weather. But absolutely, we got the new products, 2017s. We have Hobie Eclipse boards in stock that we'll get into here in a second. You know, and it's exciting. There's a buzz this year around the Hobie products specifically. Everything else, I'll be honest, in the kayak world, it's kind of flattened out, it's kind of plateaued, but the Hobie kayaks, with their innovation, their super comfortable seats, their fit, their finish, their quality, their attention to detail, their customer service, and it just bleeds over. The reason Sunjammers exist is because of my love for Hobie products. Yeah, it's as simple as that. Everything else we sell, we love, we're passionate about, from the Yeti coolers, the cups, I mean, the whole nine yards.
Go back to your roots on Hobie.
The passion for my love for Hobie. My father was a Hobie dealer 30 years before I was here on the beach. You know, him and Gary Hunley, they were partners in the Hobie shop, which is where Hooters is now. They started in the ground floor of the Sandpiper Beacon. So Hobie has been ingrained into my soul from day one. 3 months old, I was left on the beach with my aunt. Don't judge my parents, especially if you knew my aunt. Just kidding. And they were out on the beach racing Hobie 16s. Uh-huh. So that was my parents' last regatta, you know, then they realized, all right, we got to play mommy, daddy for a little while. And it was weird because then I grew up and I fell right in the footsteps. I traveled the country racing Hobie 16. I was never good, never won a race. But man, we had a blast bringing up the back of that pack. You know, we'd fly to upstate New York and, you know, racing, you know, bigger regattas all over the place. So, then here comes wife and kids. That's kind of on the back burner. You know, then here we are.
And you're still with Hobie.
Absolutely.
And that's great. I mean, he didn't just all of a sudden acquire Hobie. It goes back to when he was a kid. I want to talk about the roots of something.
We started selling Hobie for my love of Hobie from a very, very young age.
And what a quality company.
As soon as, you know, when chat room started coming on, everybody had to start making screen names and all of that, my first screen name was Hobie00 back in the eighth grade. So Hobie, I think it was, it may have been earlier than that. I was at Jinx Middle School. But Hobie's been, so we don't sell, I don't love Hobie because we sell it. I sell it because I've loved it. I've loved it. It's been, I have, you know, here's the Hobie beach towel. They finally brought them back. We have these. I have Hobie beach towels that are just tethered and wore out that my mom had that we've hung on to. So Hobie is deeply rooted in our family, and we love it. It's obvious. It comes out.
And we're talking about getting outdoors and all. They've been getting outdoors for a couple of generations now. Hobie
absolutely.
Has.
And, since 1950.
Yeah, so it fits in our program so well, and we're so honored to have Hobie as part of our sponsorship and all. The big thing now, coming out with this video, this is really nice.
Yep, it's the Hobie Mirage Eclipse Board. If you have not been living under a rock, and even if you're under that rock, I think Hobie has found a way to reach you and let you know about the Hobie Mirage Eclipse Board. When you first see it, you're like, what is that? Is it a pedal board? Is it a paddle board? Is it a gimmick? Is it a joke? No. And I had all those same thoughts because we got to see it slightly before the general public. And what it is, it's a stand-up paddle board that you don't use a paddle. So Hobie eliminated the paddle in kayaks. They've also eliminated in stand-up paddle board. So it's not called a paddle board anymore. It's called, we aren't sure what it's called. It's called the Hobie Mirage Eclipse. Super stable. We demo them almost daily in St. Andrews. We roll it out the back door. We slide it off a floating dock. I hop on it. I do a little lap around the marina so you can visually see how to do it. And then I come, I step off the dock, you step on the board, and off you go.
Okay. So this is produced by Hobie Company. We're going to go ahead and run this and then take a break and come back and talk about it. So Jeff, let's go ahead and run this one.
Thank you.
Okay, welcome back, and that's a good video.
It is, absolutely. And just we won't talk much more about it because we just want you to come down to the St. Andrews location and experience it yourself. But this is the first time since last April that we've had one on the floor that you can do what we call a cash and carry. Until this point, it's always been pre-order, and we've been pre-selling every board that we can get our hands on from the factory until this last shipment. 2 weeks ago, 2.5 weeks ago, we got a load of them. We're down to two of the big ones and one of the small ones, all maybe 3-in-1.
They're selling good.
They are. But we have more on the way. It was January. We weren't sure. If it was cold right now, we wouldn't be selling them, I'll be honest with you. Yep. But it's not cold, and we're selling them. Everybody, we got people driving over from Bluntstown, Tallahassee, mm-hmm. Dothan. They're coming to us, and they're a lot of fun.
What great exercise. And look, you can put your dog on the back.
Absolutely. And there's a picture of me, one of our local customers, Kit Carson. He brought his dog out to our demo day, and Bay hopped on the back of this, and off I went with Bay. So it's tried and true and done. So that's the Eclipse come down. Hobie also updated their kayaks for 2017. Let me rephrase that. The kayaks are exactly the same. They upgraded the Mirage Drive. As you're familiar, this is the Hobie Mirage Drive. You alternate your steps left and right, and this is what makes the paddleboard, the Hobie Eclipse, go forward with a slightly different version, and also the kayaks. But new for 2017, I guess Hobie was out running all their competition so much that they had to tweak it so the others could catch up. Just kidding, Hobie's going backwards, and I'll get to that in a second. So these are the fins. This goes forward, and these turn into hydro sails. You cannot convey this on TV, so come by either location here or St. Andrews or 79. But when you're trucking along, if you're like, I need to go backwards for a second, you pull the reverse, these flip around, you still pedal, same thing. What you did is you changed the hydrodynamics underneath here, and I probably messed that up, the terminology, okay, and you're going backwards. Then when you want to go forward, you pull it, now we're going forward. So Hobie has reverse. That was the only complaint people ever had about the Hobie kayaks is they didn't go backwards. I guess they forgot about the paddle, but you know, we'll see.
So that's Hobie has a neat idea, though.
It does, and it works really well. It's what they call full speed reverse, just for the nature of the Mirage Drive. Some of the other kayaks on the market that have pedals, they have props. In our fisheries here, props don't work. We have a very shallow bay, so when you're fishing trout, redfish,
I was going to mention that.
You either foot forward, they fold up flat with the bottom of the boat. So all you have sticking out of the bottom of the boat is about about an inch more than a regular kayak. So instead of drawing 3 inches of water, you're drawing 4 inches of water. Not a big deal, and nothing comes up above the deck, which is a huge advantage Hobie has over against all the other manufacturers.
And you get up, you know, like our shallow bay, you get up under the creeks and all, and get a little narrow. If you know what I'm talking about, you do need reverse sometimes. You don't have room to turn around if you really get up in those narrow spots.
Absolutely.
It will come in handy.
Absolutely.
That's cool.
So, and you know where all the trout and redfish are? Up in them little sloughs. Mm-hmm. You need to measure. We have the Hobie hog troughs in. We sold 1,000 of these that had sun jammers on it. When Hobie came out, you know, we're all about branding Hobie and my love for Hobie. Sometimes it kind of gets in my way of branding sun jammers sometimes. But, you know, so we have the Hobie hog troughs in stock at both locations. These are super lightweight. They're basically bump boards. Nose of the fish here, pinch the tail here. You can see how long it is. And you're good to go. And these are back in stock at all the locations.
Good. That was handy.
And all Hobies have these handy carts. You don't need any straps. There's designed scuppers, reinforced scuppers on all the Hobies for these to slip up in the bottom. And you just, like a lost puppy dog, you just grab the front handle and the kayak follows you. What's good about these is this cart will then break down to fit into one of your hatches.
Oh, yeah.
So this folds down, and I won't totally break it down here. And then I push a button here, the wheel comes off.
Oh, cool.
And Hobie even gives you a handy storage bag for it all to fit in when you're done.
Cool.
So look at there.
The wheels came off.
Yeah, the wheels came off. And then to put it back on, simply put it back on.
How about that?
Lock these in and you're good to go. Because the hardest part is, where do we put the dolly when we're kayaking? Now, there's a place on the kayak to store it. There's actually a designed place to store it. But if you have an ice chest, a dog, a kid, or something with you, then there's not room for everything.
Man, I get around this stuff, I get the fever. I want to go.
Well, let's go. What are we waiting
fishing.
On?
We got to do the show.
Oh,
you got to go to work.
Why don't y'all come with us? I got to
go
to work.
I know, so. But I don't.
That is true.
Well, this is good stuff and all. So tell everybody your location. We got to hurry and finish. Location.
St. Andrews location, which we do all of our demos now. 1129 Beck Avenue, Caddy Corner from Hunt's in the Captain's Table. You know where the boat ramp is in St. Andrews? Park in that parking lot and walk up to the bright blue building with all the kayaks and paddle boards. And then our original location, Highway 79, you head west on Back Beach Road or east on Back Beach Road. Then you're going to head north on Highway 79. We're going to be three blocks on the left. That location is closed on Sundays and Mondays. St. Andrews is only closed on Sundays.
All right. Okay. Good stuff, Brad. Let's go ahead. We've got to ask some names. We've got to do some drawing.
Sounds good.
So you do those, and I do these.
All right.
Your turn.
You want me to draw one of these?
No. Put them in here.
No.
Wait, you got to call their name.
My bad.
That's Wayne Arnold Teloja.
Donald, I can't read
Malik.
Your name. There we go.
They're from Maine.
From Maine.
And Weewall.
Woo, Maine and Weewall.
Here's a and Frida.
Frida?
Frida Malik from Weewall.
Here's Charlie from the Cove. Stan from nowhere.
Panama City.
And Delaney.
Delaney. And then we got Jason, and we got Isom Young, Defuniak Springs, Susan Hahn, Southport, Cindy Barlow, Panama City, Beer Barlow, Panama City, Ted Schubert, Freeport. We're getting around, aren't we?
Y'all sure do.
Shannon Schubert, Freeport, and Jackson Schubert, Freeport, Sam McBroom, Defuniak, and Steve McBroom, Defuniak. Okay.
Whew. Now what are we drawing for?
We're going to draw. We got our new sponsors coming on. They're going to come on, and you could be surprised. They're going to give away, but today we're going to draw for Tarpon Dock, and also for Real Time Fisheries. Let's do Real Time Fisheries. Let's do their 2 pounds of shrimp. Real Time Fisheries.
2 pounds of shrimp. I love me some shrimp. So if y'all don't eat shrimp and get this, just have them put some extra ice on there and drop it off at the St. Andrews location with my name on it.
All right, and that winner is Houston Taylor. Now Parker, that's right over his neighborhood.
Absolutely.
Very good. All right, now this is going to be Tarpon Dock, $20 gift certificate.
And if you want to get some from Tarpon Dock and bring it to me and the boys in St. Andrews, we won't say no.
Just swing it by.
I'm just saying. I can't grab one.
It's not hard now, Brad.
Yeah, it is hard. I'm dyslexic.
Amanda Whitehead from Teloja. All right, Amanda, come get your $20 certificate. I know you're going to be out of town. She's got to do some Gainesville, but... When you get back, we'll save this for you, okay? All right, now this is going to be a big red snapper.
Look at that. I'm not used to drawing three.
We're going to add another one next week, too. You watch.
Jeff Watson from Lynn Haven.
So we got Parker, Teloja, and Lynn Haven. We got to cover it with Jeff. Okay, we're going to take a quick break, come back with a famous Friday fishing report. Okay, welcome back. We're going to do our famous Friday fishing report right here, but we have it on the screen. But let's look real quick. We did last weekend. We're down to Howard Creek Landing, put in right there at the yellow dot. Went down the creek, went down to Howard Creek. Y'all see those houseboats there? We stayed on that number 27. We stayed on number 14, okay? And went catfishing and went up in Beerman's Slough. Went up in Beerman's right in here. And we didn't do it all that well, I'll be honest with you. I'm not going to tell the fish story, but we had a great time. But anyway, catfishing on Howard's Creek or anywhere up and down the river is good. All right, now let's quickly go over to St. Joe Bay. St. Joe Bay, I have not got a report from there, but I know at Mexico Beach and also at Cape San Blas, they were catching some whiting in the surf. And it's excellent fishing for whiting. This weekend, don't look good, does it?
Nope, maybe between showers. But
yeah, and like I say, yesterday, you know, don't worry about getting wet, but if you've got lightning and all, you
absolutely
don't want to stay out there. Sheephead fishing, I'll tell you a good place to go, sheephead fishing off the bridge in Apalachicola. We talked about that before too. Right here off the bridge. Okay, right there. I put it right here in the center of the screen. Okay, the little bridge that goes out there. Sheephead fishing will be good in January, February. Okay, and then also remember they're going to start sheephead at the jetties. They're going to start getting ready to do their spawn stage, and they're going to be spawning in February right here at the jetties, right here around the rocks on the east side mainly, right in there on the east side. On St. Andrew Bay, the trout bite's been pretty decent.
Yeah, I've been hearing decent trout bite up in West Bay. Redfish, if you can find them, are plentiful and they're aggressive. It's this warmer weather. The fish aren't in that lethargic state like they normally are this time of year. Like I said, they don't know it's January. They know it's 80 degrees outside and the water temperature is 66.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, here we go.
It's confusing to them, really. But you know, the trout, again, I always sort of head back toward West Bay because that's sort of a great place to go. West Bay and East Bay have been excellent as far as, you know, over the years, as far as
absolutely
producing. You know, when you have tournaments and all. And then up the intercoastal over in West Bay, you can catch some sheephead and drum right there at the West Bay Bridge, which is right up the road from Sundown.
Absolutely.
And then over in Choctawhatchee Bay, I haven't had a report from Choctawhatchee Bay. Victor Hathcote, you need to send me a report over there. I know you're fishing some over there. So anyway, it's really been a slow week.
It has been.
It really has, and you know, we have those weeks. We're not going to sit here and say that everybody's jumping in the boat because they haven't been jumping in the boat this week.
But that's all right because, remember, you can't catch them sitting on the couch. So just because somebody else didn't catch them don't mean you can't.
That's true. And we're going to have that video on that catfishing trip because it's really funny. You know, the secret is the bait on catfish. You got to get something that smells really strong. And the ideal bait is crawfish.
You want some of my socks?
No.
Not that strong. Okay, I was just curious.
We don't want to kill the fish.
Okay.
We don't want to pollute the whole Appalachian Coast Bay system. But anyway, the bait, and we debated on the bait. We had a good time on it. You'll see different bait we use, but it's interesting. But the river really gone down since last weekend, and catfishing is going to be really good this spring. And also the red horse sucker fishing will be good in March and April. So we've got a lot of things to look forward to. Spanish mackerel right around the corner.
If it keeps staying warm, we're going to have them.
It is going to be early. It really will be. We'll talk about it a lot. Also, I haven't heard anything on flounder this week.
I haven't heard many flounder.
The week before, remember we sat up here the week before, last Friday, I sat here and showed you all kind of pictures. The week before, the flounder fishing was excellent off the State Park Pier and right offshore where they were coming back in. So they're still out there. They don't disappear.
Absolutely.
So, and also the mullet, the reruns are coming back in, so it's going to be good soon.
Sounds great.
Got to wrap it up.
Just about time.
You got to go to work.
I do have to go to work. I have to go keep San Andrew salty.
Keep it salty, which is a compliment.
It is. Fantastic. Old salt, big compliment. We have these locally letterpressed signs and also pocket journals with it on it in the San Andrews location.
All right, buddy. Thank you.
Thank you.
Folks, y'all have a great weekend. Do something good for your fellow man today, and God bless.
Thanks for watching America's only daily outdoor TV show, Panhandle Outdoors with Winston Chester, featuring hunting, fishing, and other activities and information to help you enjoy the great outdoors. Join us next time for Panhandle Outdoors.